القرآن يوحدنا لطريق الخير يوجهنا الله تعالى أنزله ورسول الله معلمنا.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about making a will, and here if you notice, Allah is saying this is a duty incumbent upon the righteous. Haqqan alal muttaqeen. What does it mean? That even making a will is a sign of taqwa. Even this is a sign of taqwa. Like we had discussed earlier, the definition of taqwa, just obeying the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings a person into the fold of al-muttaqoon. And Allah also says, if somebody thinks that there is going to be some injustice in the persecution of this will, and he makes a little change so that there is justice which is given out, then there is no blame on such a person. This is the beauty of this deen. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu kutiba alaykumus siyamu kama kutiba alal ladhina min qablikum la'allakum tattaqun. O you who believe, fasting is prescribed for you as it was prescribed for those before you, so that you may learn self-restraint. Again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us, la'allakum tattaqun. Who is a muttaqi? What are the requirements of taqwa? Even when we are fasting, we are meeting that definition. Fasting is prescribed for you as it was prescribed for those before you, meaning before the Ummat-e-Muslima, the Ummahs before us were also told to fast. It was obligatory for them as well. We give up eating, drinking, we eat less, we sleep less in Ramadan, and yet we survive. What is Allah trying to show us? Allah is trying to prove our hidden potential. Normally, if somebody asks us to stop drinking water for 12 to 14 hours, it becomes so tough. We say, what? How can we do that? I'm feeling so thirsty. It's so hot. How can I stop drinking water? But when Allah's command comes, the moment, even if the glass of water is right in front of us, even if nobody is watching, we are in our own bedroom privacy, yet we will not drink. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, this is taqwa. Meaning to be afraid of Allah in public and in private, to obey Allah's commands in public and in private. This is taqwa. Fast the prescribed number of days. So Allah is showing us that you are capable. There are hidden capabilities inside each one of you which you are not aware of. Through fasting, Allah is showing us, yes, you can do it. Sometimes we want to follow Allah's commands, but we are scared. Allah says, come to my way and you will see how much you are capable of doing. Fast the prescribed number of days, except if any of you is ill or on a journey. Then fast a similar number of days later. For those who cannot endure it for medical reasons, there is a ransom. The feeding of one poor person for each missed day. Whoever does more good than this voluntarily, it is better for him. However, if you truly understand the rationale of fasting, it is better for you to fast. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what is he telling us? That fasting is compulsory. And yet, Allah gives us flexibility in deen. If somebody is sick, if somebody is so sick that he cannot fast, then Allah says it's okay. Don't fast if the doctor is telling you not to. You're not committing a sin. When you're okay, when you've regained your health, then you complete the number of days. And what about somebody who is never going to recover, who's suffering from some terminal ailment? What does he do? Should he bear that burden of guilt? No, Allah takes us out of that burden. Somebody who's very extremely old and the doctor says it's not possible for you to do it. And the doctor, of course, should be a muttaqi doctor himself. It shouldn't be just any doctor who says, no, don't do it. So for such a person, Allah says, Allah has kept a leeway. You feed one poor person for each missed day. But somebody who wants to do more than that voluntarily, then Allah says it is better. Allah says, whoever does more good than this voluntarily, then it is better for him. It is the month of Ramadan in which the Quran was revealed. Why are we fasting in this month only? To thank Allah, to show our gratitude to Allah because of the immense blessing that He blessed us with in the form of the Quran. A guidance for mankind with clear teachings showing the right way. And a criterion of truth and falsehood. Therefore, any one of you who witnesses that month should fast in it. And whoever is ill or on a journey should fast a similar number of days later on. And then, please pay attention. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ بِكُمُ الْيُسْرَ وَلَا يُرِيدُ بِكُمُ الْعُسْرَ وَلِتُكْمِلُ الْعِدَّةَ وَلِتُكَبِّرُ اللَّهَ عَلَى مَا هَدَاكُمْ وَلَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. Allah intends ease for you. And He does not want to put you into hardship. Allah does not want to make life miserable for us. If a person is traveling or if a person is sick, Allah has given him the option of not to fast at that time and to complete the number later on. And then Allah says, يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ بِكُمُ الْيُسْرَ. Allah wants you to choose the easier of the two options. Whenever Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was given two options, what did he choose? Subhanallah. He always chose the easier option, provided it was within the Sharia. If it was outside the Sharia, if it was not allowed, not permissible in Islam, he never chose it. But if it was within the Sharia, he never chose a life of difficulty. Why? Because that was the example he was setting for us. He wants you to complete the prescribed period so that you should glorify His greatness and render thanks to Him for giving you guidance. Ramadan is not only the month of fasting, it is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also told us, it is the month of the Quran. So we need to be reading, understanding the Quran more and more in this month. It was revealed in this month in the amazing night, Laylatul Qadr. Also, Ramadan is the month of du'as. Allah says, when the slave is fasting, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has told us, his du'as are accepted by Allah. So we need to make as many du'as as we can in a state of fasting. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي أَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبُ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّعِي إِذَا دَعَانِي فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُوا لِي وَلْيُؤْمِنُوا بِي لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْشُدُونَ. When my servants question you about me, tell them I am very close to them. I answer the prayer of every supplicant when he calls out to me. Therefore, they should also respond to me and put their trust in me so that they may be rightly guided. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us, make du'as in this month because I am close to you. وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي أَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. I'm close to you. I'm listening to what you are saying and I'm going to answer you. So you should also respond to me. If I'm going to answer to what you're asking me to do, should you also not do what I'm asking you to do? And put their trust in me so that they may be rightly guided. It is made lawful for you to approach your wives during the night of the fast. They are a garment for you and you are a garment for them. Allah knows that you were committing dishonesty to your souls. So He has relented towards you and pardoned you. Now you may approach your wives and seek what Allah has ordained for you. Eat and drink until the white thread of dawn appears to you distinct from the black thread of night. Then complete your fast till nightfall. Do not approach your wives during itikaf in the masajid. These are the limits set by Allah. Do not ever violate them. Thus Allah makes His revelations clear to mankind so that they may guard themselves against evil. In the night of Ramadan, Allah has made marital relations halal. This is the flexibility of Islam. And what a beautiful way of mentioning the spouses. Allah says, Hunna libasul lakum wa antum libasul lahun. Allah is calling a wife the garment of her husband and the husband the garment of the wife. What beautiful words Allah has used. If we think of what a garment does, what do clothes do to the body? Number one, they protect us. They protect our shameful parts. And in a similar way, a husband, even if he knows the wife's weakness, he's supposed to protect it, not show it to the public. And the same command is for the wife. Number two, the garments beautify the person. So a husband is the adornment for his wife. A wife is the adornment for her husband. Similarly, a garment protects us from the inclement weather. In winter, we wear thick garments. In summer, we wear cool, light garments. In a similar way, husband is supposed to give comfort to his wife and protect her from the inclement weather around her, meaning the circumstances around which may trouble her. Husband gives comfort to the wife, and the wife gives comfort to her husband. So many amazing things, and the garment cannot be separated from the body. It's very shameful to do so. So in a similar way, the husband and wife are supposed to live together and provide comfort to each other. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has called the wife a garment for her husband, and the husband a garment for his wife. And then Allah tells us the timing for fasting. Allah says, eat and drink until the white thread of dawn appears to you distinct from the black thread of night. Then complete your fast till nightfall. Why does Allah want us to notice this time and open our fast as soon as the Maghrib Azan goes, and to stop eating and drinking as soon as we know that now the time of Fajr has started? Why? Why can't we do as we please? To teach us time management, so that these lessons that we are learning in Ramadan can spill over to the rest of our lives. It is teaching us punctuality. In Ramadan, we all become so punctual. We all eat together as soon as the Maghrib Azan goes. And as soon as the Fajr Azan goes, we all stop eating. So this is teaching us time management. Allah wants us to be disciplined human beings in life. And also, what else does Ramadan teach us? That in this month, if we can give up eating halal also, food and drink which is halal for us, if we can give it up during this month, then after this month is over, can we not give up haram for the sake of Allah? This is what Allah is teaching us. It is a period of training and teaching. Every year, we are made to go through this 1 month of training. It's a training session. These are the limits set by Allah. Do not ever violate them. And do not misappropriate one another's property unjustly, nor bribe the judges in order to misappropriate a part of other people's property sinfully and knowingly. Allah is teaching us, in Ramadan you gave up eating halal. Now once Ramadan is over, please guard yourself against eating haram.
يهدنا لطريق الخير يوجهنا الله تعالى أنزله ورسوله.